Martin, tech has been experiencing exponential growth rates. Is it too late to invest in this sector?
That's a great question. We certainly think that a lot of the juice has already been squeezed from the trade. Investors have taken a binary approach to the sector in our view. That means that they've been selling old world stocks and moving entirely into the digital world. And that does make some sense given some of the definite trends that we've been seeing in the workplace, for example, with work from home, education. Google, for example, is offering a degree or a substitute for a four-year degree via a six-month program at $49 a month. And you've seen a lot of the bricks and mortars get hit with companies like JCPenney, GNC, J.Crew, and others go bankrupt. So as a result, we're seeing a lot of herding into certain segments of the market like Amazon and information technology stocks that are seeing some double-digit returns above the February highs, while other sectors like energy and financials being down significantly still from their highs.
Do you think these valuations are going to continue to go up?
Yeah, I mean, FOMO is a very powerful force. So I mean by FOMO is fear of missing out. There's also a great saying that markets can remain irrational longer than investors can remain solvent if you're trying to play the other side of that trade. So for example, if we take a look at Tesla, it's now the ninth or maybe even higher largest company in the US. It's larger than Walmart, for example, and it only has 5% of Walmart's revenue. So yeah, this can continue for some time. You're seeing some multiple expansions and that those expansions can continue, but also, you know, the US election could play a little bit of a role and there could be some risks ahead.
You mentioned the fear of missing out. Is this the primary reason why you think people are willing to pay this much for these stocks?
Yeah, and there's also been a changeover in regards to the retail investor base. It's also been a driver behind some momentum of some of these more notable names. Robinhood traders, for example, you've had a huge sports betting community that weren't able to bet on sports, but now they can on stocks. And so, you know, you're seeing investing based on certain themes and as a result, valuations becoming excessively stretched and investors looking at the returns and saying, well, we've missed out on that. You know, I have to own some of this, albeit Facebook, Microsoft, Netflix, and all of the other FANG and technology stocks.
Apart from the traditional FANGs, any other hidden gems within the tech sector, either here in Canada or on the other side of the divide?
Trying to find those hidden gems is very difficult because the money has, the capital flow into the sector has been so pervasive. I've spent some time trying to dig down deeper into some of the more unknown, lesser known names, but the valuations in anything tied to the supposedly digital transformation of the economy has done very well. We're seeing that in IPOs. We're seeing that a lot of the SPAC, for example, the IPOs, everything is being geared towards capturing that money. So it's becoming a lot more difficult to find opportunities within that digital transformation and that trade in itself.